Hello everyone. My name is Dr. Advait Kulkarni. I am a senior consultant neurologist practicing in Bangalore at my own clinic, HSR Neuro Clinic. And I'm a visiting consultant at Manipal and Narayana Group of Hospitals. Myasthenia Gravis is a disease which happens because of weakness of the neuromuscular junction, the place where the nerve and the muscle meet. That junction is a chemical called acetylcholine. If there is a weakness of that junction, patients may experience various symptoms. The most important and initial symptom can be drooping of eyelids, double vision, the patient will see two instead of one, and which might disappear after closing one of the eyes. Patient may experience fatigability, like, doctor, I am walking for 1 kilometer, half a kilometer, now I feel very tired and I'm not able to walk more than half a kilometer. I'm getting a lot of pains in my legs and hands. I'm not able to lift weights. I'm not able to do physical activity, exercise. So fatigability can be a symptom of myasthenia gravis along with eye symptoms. Some patients may experience swallowing difficulty. Doctor, when I'm swallowing, I am tending to cough. When I swallow liquids, it comes out from the nose. Or there can be change in voice, like a nasal twang. They may talk with a nasal twang to the voice. These are the various symptoms of myasthenia gravis. It is an autoimmune disease wherein there are antibodies against this acetylcholine receptors, and the treatment is very, very simple. There are medications, and the doctor, the neurologist, will do your tests to see whether you have a thymoma. Thymus is a gland which will secrete excess antibodies in adults. Typically, it becomes rudimentary by the time one is 15 to 20 years of age. But in some cases, the thymus remains, and there can be a thymic tumour or a thymic enlargement which might need treatment. So the treatment includes medications, evaluation of the thymic gland and removal if there is a thymic tumour, and depending on the stage of the disease and the severity, one might need admission, one might need IV steroids and IV immunoglobulin along with oral medications. The usual treatment of myasthenia is a long-term treatment, and it needs a regular follow-up with your neurologist. So it is very important to meet your neurologist if you have these symptoms and get yourself treated well in time.